Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're gonna talk about another new knife from Southern Grind Knives out of Peachtree, Georgia, which is a company founded and run by Zach Brown from the Zach Brown Band, as you can see on the packaging right here. And the knife we're gonna talk about today is a really, really special design that at first wasn't really my cup of tea, but as long as I owned it, it really, really grew on me, and I think it's something that more people should check out just because it is very, very surprisingly good. And that is the Southern Grind Quill. That looks like this. A super sleek, super slender Wharncliffe style blade. 14C28N Sandvik blade steel, a steel that Southern Grind has been using for quite a long time. Their first knife also featured that steel, the Bad Monkey. Here we have titanium handle scales. They're going again with their theme of animals on the pivot screw right there. This one seems to be a hedgehog or a porcupine, something like that. Also, you notice the shape of the pivot screw. That means it's not going to be a free spinning pivot, but still going to be nicely adjustable with T8 or T10 Torx bit right there. Regular construction. Some nice red aluminum backspacers right there. Other than that, a clean titanium scale and a titanium frame lock without any kind of insert running on bearings. And the action on this thing is absolutely amazing, especially considering the lightweight nature of the whole package and especially the thin and sleek blade. So action here is just really an extremely amazing thing and something that I hadn't expected, especially of a knife in this format. You can also see you have a pretty prominent flipper tab right there with some jimping that works actually absolutely perfectly for a light switch opening. You also have a very nice and defined detent, so that works super nice, as you can see right here. And just overall, an extremely nice and sleek gentleman style folder from Southern Grind. You also have their proprietary and pretty signature shortened pocket clip. Hardware is a little bit blackened, and now let's take a look at the specs of this knife, which are a little bit particular, especially in this dimension here. So we have an overall length of 7 inches or 18 centimeters. It gives us a blade length of just around 3 inches or 7.7 centimeters. As I said before, the steel is 14C28N Sandvik steel, which is a very, very good mid-range steel in my opinion. It's Swedish steel from Sandvik. It has good edge retention, very good rust resistance and good toughness. Very nice blade steel, actually developed for use in cutlery. And we have a 3mm thick blade spine. We're gonna revisit the steel and how it relates to the price of this knife a little bit later on. We have a good long run of jimping here on the spine of the quill that actually is very, very nicely done, provides a good amount of traction. And also the ergonomics on the quill right here are actually quite surprisingly good, even though it's a super slender and pretty standard shape here, but you don't feel like you're not holding on to something. It's actually a quite usable overall concept. Of course, it's not going to be as hand-fitting as a full-sized brawl handle, like for example here the Southern Grind Penguin, which has a lot more to hold on to, but it actually feels much, much better than I had anticipated just from pictures that I had seen on the internet. Here you can see the steel marking as well. Other than that, we have a gorgeous stone wash here on the blade. This heavier stone wash that Southern Grind does on their blades. We have the same here on the Penguin. Also same titanium finish. It's a little bit shinier media blasted finish. You know, I'm a big fan of the a little bit darker finish that Chris Ree, for example, uses. It also gives you a little bit of a haptic feedback here. You have pretty smooth scales, some nice chamfering along the edges. Stop pin right there, flow through construction. And getting back to the scales and the size here, we have a handle length of 4 inches or 10 centimeters. And let's take a look at the width here in comparison to, let's say, a regular pen. Here we have a Fisher Space pen in the polished version, and in the open position you can see it's not much wider than a pen like this. And also lengthwise, if you close it down, these two make actually a very good pair. And it's not much wider than a pen, as you can see right here. So very, very interesting approach to a easy to carry, easy concealable, gentleman style, office style carry folder here with the quill, and something I haven't seen from any other maker actually. So this is a concept that I hadn't thought about, and actually is much more useful and capable than I actually anticipated in the beginning. Also, a thing that is very impressive on this knife and that you might expect is the weight. We have here an overall weight of the Southern Grind quill of just 51 grams or 1.8 ounces at a blade length of 3 inches, which is pretty amazing overall, and just shows you that this is an absolute featherweight that packs a lot of cutting edge into an extremely easily carried format. And I also love the swetch here. The overall blade shape is just gorgeous and certainly makes the name very suitable quill, but it doesn't get a needle thin tip, so the tip is actually quite robust. Also, because we have a super super slender blade like this, there is not a lot of travel on that flat grind that we have on this blade, so that means it's going to be a little bit thicker behind the edge, but it actually cuts very well and came impressively sharp from Southern Grind. So absolutely no problem in EDC use. And of course the sandwich steel that we have on this knife strops up very very nicely, and is also much easier to sharpen than, for example, an M390 or S90V or something like that that we have, for example, here on the Penguin. I'm really a big fan of the pivots that Southern Grind does. I think that gives just so much character to the blade. We can also notice that on the quill here we have a matte finished pivot. On the other Southern Grind knives that I had so far, it's actually always this more brushed or polished finish that I have on the pivot screw. As I said before, the finish on the blade is actually very, very similar to all the other Southern Grind knives that I had with a stonewashed finish. We have actually 3 knives from Southern Grind right now on the channel or in my collection that all feature different steels, so they really have something to offer for all the steel snobs, and also some a little bit less expensive steels as well. So here we have S35VN, S90V, and 14C28N, which in my opinion all are great steels in their own right and with their own little specialties regarding that. Of course, in the grand scheme of things, the general rating would be this is the most edge retaining steel than S35VN and then 14C28N, but as you know, sharpening and toughness and corrosion resistance will vary as well. Here you can also see a good size comparison if you have any of these Southern Grind knives. You can see they are pretty close in overall length, but you can also appreciate the super super slender nature of the quill in this comparison, in my opinion. So that is certainly a good thing to notice here. From here we can actually jump into the rest of our size comparisons that I have prepared for you. The one that comes actually the closest is a knife that in other regards is pretty different, and that is going to be here the Lion Steel Dom, which is the Wharncliffe version of the Roundhead from Lion Steel, here with custom Birdswift knives, marbled carbon fiber scales, as he was actually making scales. Now he's building full-fledged customs, so congratulations to that move in the career. But here you can see this knife is actually pretty much identical or slightly smaller in the overall length, as you can see here, but width-wise super comparable. Actually the quill is slightly more slender in this dimension than a traditional, so that is certainly traditional pattern. The knife itself features modern materials, but overall this is actually one of the best comparisons that I could come up with in my collection. That shows you also that this is a little bit a more unique kind of approach to a gentleman's folder. Here we have another very sleek gentleman's folder, but this is actually quite a bit larger, and that is the Jeff Park Designs Bones, which is the Mid-Tech version of a custom design that also was released in collaboration with CRKT and called the Crossbones. But you can see here we have quite a bit of a difference in overall length. And even though the Crossbones or the Bones is actually a more slender knife in the grand scheme of things, you can see the Quillerite here is just in its own league regarding slenderness and ease of carry. So getting all these other knives out of the way and taking another closer look at the overall construction, we have some interesting jimping placement right in the front, right here, which actually I'm not quite sure what the purpose is of this, if they want to use this as more of a Kubaton style punching device, or it's just there for some aesthetic cues, or they want to have that to aid in deployment. I can't actually really say, but that is just something to note. We have some nice added jimping at some crucial points. We have the lock bar cutout on the outside, comes pretty nicely centered slightly off to the non-locking side there. And what me really impressed on this knife was actually the lockup. We have here a titanium on steel lock interface. Take a look here a little bit closer. No over travel stop, nothing like that. We have a good cutout for the disengagement of the liner of the frame lock, and absolutely rock solid lockup running on captured stainless steel bearings. And the action when I disengage that lock is just super amazing. It's along the lines of the servo I had. It's just super, super nice. And you can also appreciate the snappiness of that detent. Very, very impressive. And especially for the weight and size of this blade, I haven't seen a knife that pulls that up as well as the Quillerite here. And I think this is certainly a knife that is vastly underappreciated in the knife community, because most people probably think at the size and steel that it offers, at the a little bit special overall appearance that it has, the price point is a little bit up there, which I can agree with, especially if you haven't handled a quill. But I would highly recommend you to get into a store or go to a show and try to handle one of these quills, because the quality here, the action, and just the overall concept and how it fits in my particular hand is just extremely surprising. This is one of the knives that surprised me absolutely the most positively, and I'm pretty glad that I picked this quill up here. Just overall extremely interesting way of interpreting a gentleman's EDC office style carry with a good length of blade, but just slimmed down to the most possible to give it the appearance of a pen when you're carrying it with this clip, which is a little bit on the more tense side. But you can see you have some spring to it, but it's one of a more tense clips. It's also not touching the frame right here, as you can see. So if you have thicker pockets, this is going to be a little bit of a bind, but I think this is actually built to run in slacks, to run in dress shirts and things like that, just next to a pen. So if you have to open a leather or cut a box, you will have a very good companion at your side, and as that, this functions really well. Of course, it's not going to be your hard use everyday working man's blue collar beater, but for a gentleman's office carry, I think this is really one to beat. It looks very interesting, looks a little bit aggressive, but not too much. The Wharncliffe blade is super easy to strop and sharpen and gives you a nice, long, usable edge. Overall, the handle is pretty comfortable. As you can see here, I have small to medium hands, fits my hand perfectly, and it's just super, super well made with very good materials. The price on the Southern Grind quill right here runs just around $270 for a made in the USA titanium frame lock with 14C28 Sandvik steel from Southern Grind. And that is certainly a little bit up there, especially comparing it to what's out there in the competition. But Southern Grind has a very nice thing going on. That is their purpose of being a knife company, and that is to support Camp Southern Ground, which is their charitable branch of business that was also created by Zac Brown of the Zac Brown Band, and all the profits of Southern Grind go actually to the benefit of that camp that deals with children and families with a military background with some learning disorders and things like that. So they really have a great cause in their knife company. That is also why I really like to support this brand, and they build amazing knives. I have to say I'm a big fan of all the Southern Grind knives that I had. I also have a couple of fixed blades from them that actually are super great performance, great overall designs, extremely ergonomic. They're called the Jackal and Jackal Pop. I had the Bad Monkey, which was a little bit too large for me. I have a pretty cool Tanto blade that is also sport the 14C28N steel that the Quill has right here. Really like that, performed very well with that steel. And as you know, 14C28N is one of my absolute favorite mid-range steels. Just because of all of its properties, and it has very nicely performed for me. And I think on the Quill for that price point, I actually would have liked to have seen a little bit of higher end steel. It would be awesome with the S90V, but then again, S90V for a knife with this purpose in mind would have maybe been a little bit of an overkill, or just offer this knife at a slightly lower price point. Also, a carbon fiber version would be awesome, especially for these office style carries, and just a bunch of anodizing colors or a milling pattern would have been super nice as well. But as it is right now, I'm super impressed with the Southern Grind Quill, and the action on this knife is just something that is beyond belief, especially at the dimensions that we sport here. And it actually is a usable knife, and that was also something that I was impressed with, how much work I can do comfortably and how much work I could done with this blade length. And most of the time you don't need a broad blade or anything like that, you just need a little bit of longer cutting edge to cut through an apple, to do things like that. And for that, these smaller, more slender knives, like for example here, the Quill, work really well. Of course, you get a little bit of a broader area here with the flipper tab, because it's a little bit a larger flipper tab, but I think this is also the reason why it has an amazing flipper action, as you can appreciate right here. Maybe I'll show you again the detent. Very nice and snappy. And just overall, if you don't have a lot of space, if you don't want to show the fact that you have a knife in your workplace, but you need a knife for opening letters, packages, things like that, I think the Quill would be a great piece while contributing to a great cause with Southern Grind and just carrying a badass little gentleman's folder all day long. So this was my review of the Southern Grind Quill, great gentleman's folder. One thing that I might would like to see is a deep carry version of their short style clip, more along the lines of a bug out clip or something like that. That would certainly add into the concealability factor, because as it is right now, you carry about like this in your pocket and it looks a little bit like an odd pen. But that's just an aside. Other than that, I'm very impressed with this knife and would certainly recommend to check it out if you're that kind of a lighter use office style EDC guy. And if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave them down below. And if you are looking to get another knife for your collection, please check out White Mountain Knives and use my discount code 7READY for 10% off your entire order. And if you want to see more of these knife gunning gear videos, subscribe to my channel and my Instagram, 7READY_knives_reviews. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.